What's up, guys? Your Bigly here. A lot of you have been asking me about home-based dumbbell-only workout for the whole body, and today I'm gonna teach you only that. But along with that, I'm gonna introduce you to the Bowflex family of dumbbells. Instead of getting multiple pairs of dumbbells, you get multiple pairs of dumbbells in a single piece. How's that? You have adjustable knobs on both the sides. All you have to do is adjust them and lift, and you get the resistance that you require. Okay, so what are we gonna see today? I'm gonna teach you 6 basic exercises with which you can hit all the major muscle groups of the body and keep your body extremely fit and strong. So the number one exercise that we are gonna do is deadlift. The reason why I prefer doing deadlift first is because it expends a lot of energy. Some people prefer starting with the legs. I prefer starting with the back. And whenever you choose to do exercises, you travel from the larger muscle groups to the smaller supporting muscle groups so that you're able to carry out that intensity from the beginning till the end without any trouble. So right now, I'm adjusting the weights to 9 pounds on each side. Because I'm just gonna be demonstrating, I'm not gonna lift a lot of weight, but here we go. Deadlifts, exercise number one. The most important thing that you need to notice while doing deadlift is keeping your back straight and in perfect arch. And while coming on top, make sure you lock your shoulders and don't rotate. This is wrong, but all you need to do is come up and lock your shoulder. That's all it is. A beginner can do 3 sets of 8 to 10 reps. And if you're advanced, I would recommend you to go for 5 sets between 15 and 8 repetition. Exercise number 2, inclined dumbbell presses. When it comes to chest, a lot of people prefer doing only the flat, but I prefer doing inclined after understanding the body, after working with lots of athletes. When you're looking at a broad shoulder look, that is the V taper, the most important muscle from the front side is going to be your chest, and only when you have a thick upper chest, you can display that width in your shoulders. So I prefer inclined dumbbell presses. First, position yourself well in the bench. Give gentle thrust with your thighs. Lie down and go for the presses. If you are a beginner, I would recommend 3 sets of 8 to 10 reps. And if you are advanced, just like your deadlift, 5 sets of 15 to 8 reps. When I say 15 to 8 reps, each set try to increase the weight and go with higher resistance. Exercise number 3 is going to be shoulder presses. And this is the bread and butter of building a broad shoulder. So the reason why I chose back first was because of this. Back is a pulling movement. Your chest and shoulder are both pushing movement. So in that order, we'll go for shoulders, and chest is bigger than shoulders. So we did chest first and shoulder presses. Position the dumbbell adjacent to your ears. Press it all the way up and down. Some people have the habit of going and hitting the dumbbell. This could be hazardous when you go heavy, because this hitting can generate momentum and create injury in your rotator cuff. Same as all the other exercises, 3 sets of 8 to 10 reps for beginners, and 5 sets of 15 to 8 reps for advanced. Whoever goes to gym when it is a boy, the most important body parts that they train are gonna be arms. So I train my triceps first and then go for biceps. The reason is simple. Triceps has 3 heads and it occupies 2/3 of your upper arm, and the biceps occupies only 1/3 of your upper arm. So I'm gonna be doing some triceps exercise. I'm gonna be doing 2-arm triceps extension. So I'm just increasing the load. So there is 11 pounds on each side in this dumbbell. When you're doing a 2-arm, always position the dumbbell well and then push it overhead. A lot of people just take it up with momentum like this. This is where they get injured. So pushing it properly, lift it all the way up. Go for a complete extension and then go up and contract your triceps. I see a lot of guys doing ego lifting in this, doing just half reps. Remember this, guys. Half reps build only half muscle. Full reps build full muscle, literally. Because we have already used our triceps in the previous 2 pushing movements, 2 sets would be more than enough for beginners, and 3 to 4 sets would be more than enough even for the advanced lifters. Next, biceps. This is a dream muscle for every boy. Whenever you talk about strength, flexing those biceps is the most important thing that you see. And I always prefer doing hammer curl against the regular dumbbell curls which people do. The reason is simple. Hammer hits even your brachialis, which is underneath your biceps, that helps you lift your biceps up. So I've again gone back to the standard weight of 9 pounds on each side of the dumbbell handle. And here we go. No momentum, controlled reps, full contraction, full stretch. If you prefer doing it in alternate fashion, that's also okay. Again, you can do 2 sets of 8 to 10 reps if you are a beginner, and 3 to 4 sets of 15 to 8 reps if you are an advanced athlete. We've come to almost the end of the segment. The most important body part, which is neglected by half of the gym going crowd, legs. Guys, when it comes to legs, remember this. There are a lot of anabolic hormones that get secreted in your body. And scientific research shows that when you squat, do an intense leg workout, all these anabolic hormones are secreted in surplus. If you are a man, just imagine what extra testosterone can do for you. I'm gonna be demonstrating ply squats today. So I've adjusted it to 14 pounds on each side. Keep your legs wide, toes pointed outwards. Squat all the way down until you feel the stretch in the glute. Chest up, and when you come up, contract your glute. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12. Why did I do less reps on the upper body exercises and you see me going a little high on the lower body? Here is a simple tip and a takeaway for you all. There are different types of fibers in the body, where the type 2 fibers respond to heavy load and speed of your rep, that is the speed of the contraction. And the type 1 fibers are endurance type. Because we humans have evolved by walking and running a lot, we have more endurance fibers in the leg. So if you want to thoroughly exhaust the muscles, you need a little bit of more reps. So that's it, guys. Simple 6 exercises using a pair of dumbbells. You can hit your entire body. Do it 3 times a week, Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. And on non-training days, just go for 40 minutes of walk or some other cardio. You will be super fit. It's your Big Lee, over and out.